Hi guys, now I want to create a small single page web application using Angular 4. I have created this application in my tutorial of AngularJS 1. If you want to learn developing this single page web application with Angular 1, I have given the link of that video in the description below. Check that out. But in this video, I'm going to create this application in Angular 4. And in the previous videos that I have been creating of Angular 4, I have been teaching you few important concepts and techniques for binding for different things. I will be using all those concepts to create this application, plus a few more important things like how to add a click event on the buttons in Angular 4, how to bind any attribute value without interpolation. So in this application, I can add different items, text item. We can have a bunch of other things right here, but I can just add this text right now, and I can remove any text that I want. If I click on this cross button, it's gonna remove. Click on any cross button, it's gonna remove. If I want to add another new item in that list, I can just click on it and write anything inside it and click on add. It's going to add right here, and I can add as much item as I want. If I add anything and this contains empty string, it's not going to add anything in that list, and I can then remove the new items that I have just added. So this is what I'm going to develop in this Angular 4 tutorial. So in my code, I have nothing but the default settings that I have the title app stocks and my HTML, and inside this HTML I have the title that is bind with this property. And I'm also going to write some CSS in my app.component.css file, and write HTML and write the code inside this class to get our single page web application works. So first of all, I need to write few HTML inside my app.component.html, and I'm going to remove the previous code that is written in my HTML, and I'm going to write first div, and I'm going to give it the name of my class main. And after that, I'm going to add h1 element, and inside it I'm going to write items list. And after this h1 element, I need to add a div. It has a class, and this class contains add item. So in this div, I'm going to add the input text box and a button. So I will write input. It has a placeholder, and placeholder would be add item, and it has a class. Let's say it has a class of add text. And after this input element, I need to add a button, and this button has a text add. So let's save this file and see what we have right now. We have the items list heading, and we have a text box, and we have the button. So now I need to add another div. Actually, let's not add a div. Instead, I'm going to add unordered lists. And after that, I will add a list element. And inside this list, I need to add all the elements that I'll be adding right here. So I'm not going to add any constant value inside my list right now. Let's say I have ABC. This is an element that has to be shown. And along with this element, we need to have a span. And within that span, I need to add X character to close our or to remove any particular item. So this is what, and I'm going to write CSS to style this list a bit. Okay, and I don't think that I need to write and add any class. Instead, I'm directly going to add style components for my li tag and ul tag. So let's save this file, and I'm going to go to my CSS file to write some CSS code. So first of all, I have this main class. So I will write main dot main, and I need to give it a width, and that has to be 500. I have text align that has to be center. I have margin That is zero auto. I have the border, 2 pixels, solid, and the border needs to be dark gray. So I will write D7, 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 and I'm going to remove the border bottom. So now I need to add margin top, 20 pixels, and font family that has to be sans serif. So let's save this file, and I need to navigate to it. So you can see that we have added some styling for our main class. Now we need to add some CSS styling attributes for our heading, for our other elements added in our HTML. So now after this main class, I need to add h1, and h1 has to be text align, that has to be center, background color that has to be a dark bluish color. So I will write 5c8297, and after that I need to add the padding of 30 pixels and 0 pixel, margin top 0 pixel, and color has to be white. After the h1 element, let's check that out. So it is working. Now we need to style this text box and our button. So for the text box and the button, I need to write first of all the add item, and I need to write position relative, padding bottom has to be 0, and height has to be, let's say, 30 pixels. And after that we have a class add text. So add text, and its styling should be width 80%, height 30 pixels, padding 5 pixels, font size 20 pixels. And I need to add some styling elements for my button, which is inside add item class. So I will write height 45 pixels, width 50 pixels, padding 5 pixels. So let's save this one, and you can see that our styling is working. Now we need to style our list elements that we have just written right here. So we have the UL element, we have the li element, and the span. So come back to our CSS file, and I'm going to write UL. First of all, I need to remove the bullet points. So I list style needs to be none, font style needs to be 20 pixels, color needs to be 686868, and that is dark gray color. And we have the margin left, that has to be minus 40 pixels, and margin bottom 0 pixels. And now we need to write style for li element. So it has a border bottom 1 pixels, solid, and BF BF BF. Okay, and I need to write colon right here, and after that I need to add some background. So background color, I want to add this one, And after that, I need to add padding, 10 pixels and 0 pixels, margin bottom, and that is 5 pixels. So let's go back and see what we have right here. Okay, so last thing we need to do is we need to bring this X character to the right side, and we have the X character within our span element. So I'm going to write the last style for our span. So that is the cursor pointer. If I hover my cursor on it, it should show as a pointer. And position needs to be relative and float right. Margin right, I don't want it to be at the right side a lot. So you can see that we have our element item that we will be adding from here, and we have this. Now it's not doing anything. Right now we need to write our TypeScript and JavaScript code, and we need to bind those properties with our HTML. So let's come back to our HTML, and first of all, let's come back to our app.component.ts, and I'm going to add an array, and that will be containing the default elements that will be shown in our list at the start of our application. So I'm going to remove this title, and I need to define an element, a property called item equals to, and within this array, let's say I want to add Angular 4, and we have a React, and let's add the third element, let's say a JavaScript library underscore. So let's save this file and let's come back to our HTML. And now I'm going to bind this list of items, right now it's an array, with this UL element. And I'm going to show all these three items, no matter how many elements are in this array, it's going to show up within this LI element. And I have shown you in the previous two videos how to use ng4 for iterating through all the items and show each item in our list. So within this li element, I'm going to write steric ng4 equals to double quotes, and I'm going to write let I of items, and these items are this attribute I is small. Okay, and after that, rather than adding abc, I need to bind each item in my li element, and I'm going to use interpolation within these double curly braces, and I'm going to write the name of this variable that is receiving each item from these items. So let's save this file and let's come back, so you can see that all the elements are being shown up right here. We have Angular 4, React underscore, and we can't remove an individual item right now, and we can't add new item right now. So we have bind our list in our li element. So right now, let's write our code for adding new item from writing this input text. And if I click on this add button, it's going to show up in that list. So let's come back to our app.component.ts file. And now I need to add another variable, and that's going to contain a new value that's going to be written in this text box. So after these items, I need to write a new item, and that is at start it's going to contain nothing but an empty string. And after that, I'm going to define a function, push item, and it's gonna have a function instance. And first of all, I need to check if this dot new item is not equals to empty, then add a new item. Otherwise, we don't need to add that empty item in our list. So this dot items dot push this dot new item, because this is how we push new item in our array. Okay, so after that, I need to make my new item empty again. Once our new item is added in our list, it needs to be empty again. So let's save this file. It will not be shown up right here, but if I go back to my HTML, I need to bind this new variable with this input element, because if I write anything inside it, it should reflect the change in this variable. This is called two-way binding. If we write something from here, it should shown up within this input element. And if I write something in my input element at runtime from my application, it should be added in this variable automatically. Okay, I'll show you right now, but first I need to write some code to bind this variable with this HTML. So in order to bind it, I need to first write a square brackets, and within this square bracket I need to write parentheses, and within these parentheses I need to write ng model. Okay, and after that I need to write equals to double quotes, and within this double quotes I need to write the name of that variable. So I'll copy this variable and paste it within this property. Okay, if I save this file and save both the files, you can see nothing has been shown because it has been binded with this property, and this property is empty at start. If I write something inside it, ABC, and let's save this file, you can see that has been shown right here. Okay, because that is being binded with this input element. Okay, and if I will change something from here, it's automatically gonna reflect this variable. And when this variable is going to be changed, I am pushing this variable within this array in my push item function. Right here I am pushing this variable, the value of this variable in this item. Okay, so right now I need to add a click event on my button so that if I write anything inside it, it's going to add up in my new item variable. And if I click on that button, it's going to call this function, and this function is going to push that new item in my array, and that array is going to be reinitialized. And when this array is going to be reinitialized, it's going to this ng for, it's going to repeat all the items of this array. Okay, so I hope you understand. Let me complete it and I'll explain you again. So for adding a click event on this button and calling this function, I need to write something called a parenthesis, and inside this parenthesis I need to write something called click, and after that equals to double quotes. Okay, and within this double quotes I need to call that function push item. Okay, so let's save both the files. And first, at start I need to make in my TS file, I want to make this string empty. Okay, so now let's add a JavaScript. So if I click on add, it's going to show up in my list, and that has become empty. So what's going on right here? I'm writing in my input element, and it is binded with this variable, and that variable value is going to be changed right here. And after writing something in my input element, I'm going to click on this button, and this button is going to call this function. And in this function I am checking if that element is empty or not. If it is not empty, mean it is filled with some value, I'm going to push this new item in this array, and this array is changed now because it contains a new item right now. And when this array is going to be changed, it's going to trigger and let this ng for that the items have been changed, items have been upgraded. So it's going to iterate all the new items of this items array again. So now items contains four items. It's going to iterate through, and all the four items will be shown up in my list. I can add any item that I want, but I need to add a click event on these cross buttons to get this thing work. And I need to add that click event on my this span. Okay, so same as I added a click event on my button, I will write click within the parentheses and I will add a double quote, and I'm going to let's keep it empty right now. Let's add our remove item function first. So remove item function index. Okay, so what is this index show? This index will contain the index number. There is an error. Let me remove this one because it is showing me some error. So this is at the 0th index. This is at the first index. This is at the second index. So from my HTML, I'm going to send out the index number of the item that contains this element. If I click on this one, it's going to send that function 1 because this is at the 1 index. If I click on this cross button, it's going to send out 0 index. Okay, so I will show you that how we can detect an index from this ng for, but right now let me come back to this function and write code with this index that it's going to receive from that click event. So inside it, I need to write this dot items. An array contains a function. This is a JavaScript function called splice, an index and 1. So it's going to use that array, and from that array, it's going to remove that item that comes at this particular index. If this contains 0, it's going to remove the 0th element from that array, and 1 indicate that remove 1 item starting from this index. So I need to remove just 1 item, so that's why I have written 1. Now I need to call this function and send out the index number from that HTML. So to find out the index number from that ng for, we need to write few more code after the items variable. So after that, I need to write a semicolon, and I will write let. I need to define the name of variable that is going to store the index number of any particular item. So IND, I'm going to name it IND. We can name it anything. And after that, I'm going to store it index. And this is a keyword. We can't change its name. And this show, this indicate the index number of individual item. And when we will click on this cross button, I need to send this particular index because I'm storing this index in this variable. So I will send this variable each time I'll click on this X button. So I will write click equals to double quotes remove item, and I'm going to send IND, which is the in this index. Okay, let me save this file and save this file as well. So this file has been reloaded. And if I click on this cross button, it's going to receive this React, this one, because this is at the first index. So click on it. Nothing has been removed. So the reason was that it wasn't removing. I inspected that file, and because of some reason, this line of code wasn't showing up in this function. So I came back to that TS file and removed this line and rewrite this line within this function. So then I saved this file, and this line showed up within this function. So now if I click on and add a debugger right here, and if I click on this cross button and check what's inside this index, you can see that it has 1. Okay, so this index contains 1 because React at 1 index, and if I let it run, so you can see that's gone. And I can add new item. Let's add few more items. So these items have been added, and I can remove any item if I click on any cross button of individual item. If I click on it, it's gone. If I click on it, it's gone. So all the list items are being shown up. We can add item, we can remove item. That was a pretty small single page application. So that was it for this tutorial. I just want all of you to keep subscribing my channel for getting notified for my upcoming Angular 4 videos, and make sure you like this video. Thanks for watching.